Hello, my name is Justin Gonzalez, and welcome to It Worked, where I review educational apps, tech, and projects that work in the classroom. Today, we're going to look at some settings that every teacher should know if they use Zoom with their students. This video will walk you through some useful settings that you may want to turn on or off based on how you plan on using Zoom with your students. By going to a browser and typing zoom.us, you'll be able to access your settings for your account. On the left side, click on Settings. And this will bring you some settings for security, in-meeting basics, in-meeting advanced, and other. The first feature I want to highlight is the waiting room. With the waiting room enabled, this allows you to control who enters your Zoom meeting. When students click to join your meeting, they'll be prompted to wait for the host to allow them to enter. This ensures that only your students are entering the Zoom meeting and it is a secure place for learning. You will notice that throughout this video, some features are turned on or off and locked by my account admin. If you do not have a school account, then you will want to make sure that you change these features. When scheduling a meeting, you can choose to have your video off for the host and participants when they enter the meeting. With this enabled, you are able to make sure that you are ready for the camera before you admit students into the Zoom meeting. I have Join Before Host turned off because I don't want students to join the meeting without me present. As to not distract other students or to take away from my meeting, I have Mute Participants Upon Entry turned on. In the In-Meeting Basics section, I have Chat enabled. This allows for me to share links and answer questions from participants within the chat window. With the proper norms in place, you can have students ask and answer questions within the chat window. I disabled Private Chat, which allows two participants to send private messages to one another. If you are sharing your screen or busy presenting information to students, you might not know that someone is waiting in the waiting room. I turned on Sound Notification when someone joins or leaves for the host and co-hosts only. This ensures that I hear when someone is waiting. By enabling co-host, you give another participant the same controls as the host. If you have a co-teacher, you'll want to share these settings with them. Once they log in, you can click on their name in the participant panel and then make co-host. Another feature that you can turn on is polling. I will discuss this feature in an upcoming video. With annotation enabled, you allow participants to write on the screen. With the proper norms in place, this can be a very helpful tool. For my purposes at the beginning of the school year, I have this feature turned off. A quick way to get student feedback is by asking them for quick yes or no responses. Students can access raise hand, yes or no from the participant panel. This allows for you to gauge where students are or if you need to slow down. Another feature that I'll discuss in a future video is breakout rooms.
I hope you found this video useful. If there's other settings in Zoom that you use, drop them below in the comments. Thanks for watching.